Guys, welcome to November's video. So last month I touched on post-rut and doe fawns coming into heat late and deer getting back on food sources. Well, that is exactly what 3 days after we filmed that episode, I went out behind my house. I had a young doe fawn come into the food plot and my target deer goalpost, he came in with her and
Go down. Oh my gosh, go down. He's down. He just went down. Oh my gosh, I got him.
The rest is history. I got him. He is one of the most meaningful deer to me. He's kind of the deer that I've centered and built the whole Building Whitetail series for 2020 around. I don't have a big, massive chunk of property here. I had a small area, but we kept the key fundamentals and goalposts is down. And he's an awesome, awesome buck. I'm very thankful for him. So with deer tag punched, we're gonna roll right into trapping season. I'm gonna start you guys out from everything you need to get started from. We're gonna start from ground zero and all the way to setting steel. This month we're gonna go over what you need. Next month is we're gonna actually go out and we're gonna make sets. We're gonna run a trap line. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Guys, I cannot wait to take you with me. Okay guys, so we're gonna start pretty basic. Catching raccoons, if you have deer feeders, or honestly, raccoons are just a problem for a lot of people on a lot of properties. Dog-proof trap is as easy as it gets outside of using a box trap. I use these, I love these traps. This is a Z trap. There's several different makes and models. You can buy them on F&T, you can buy them online, you can buy them on Amazon, I think. And then this other thing you'll need is the Earth Anchor. You can buy these at Kendall Overmeyer's KO Extreme store, you can buy them on F&T Trapping Post. They're a very useful tool in dog proofs as well as the footholds, which we'll show later in the video. The baits I use personally, I use two different kinds. I use a purchase bait. Kendall has one that's specific for dog proofs, works really great. And the other one I use is marshmallows with vanilla extract. Oftentimes I'll switch it up and use, you know, if I set half a dozen of these, I'll set three of one bait, three of a different bait and just mix it up. Works really well. You can really take care of a lot of problematic coons with these real quickly. Okay guys, onto the foot trap portion. These are the KO Extreme trap. These are the ones that I prefer to use. Make sure that in your state that you read specifically through all your trapping laws, rules, and regulations. That is very, very important. Make sure that you purchase trap tags with your name on it. You can have them made on a lot of different sites, F&T, you just punch it in, they'll send you copper trap tags that you can trap your traps with. That is very, very important. Make sure to always follow your rules and regulations for where you're at. This is my favorite trap for coyotes and bobcats. Works excellent for raccoons, skunks, possums, so on and so forth. Great trap. You will also need to purchase trap screen covers, these specific ones for the KO Extreme from Kendall's website. Love these things. You'll need a couple hammers because you're going to lose one. Make sure they're good hammers. Drivers. Okay, so this, you can't buy this. This is mine. But you can buy a Earth Anchor driver. Bear with me here. And I'll show you guys how to do this in the next video, but this is how you drive and anchor your traps into the ground. just look up there under anchoring and these will come up. If you have any questions, call these guys. They're great people and they will help you out as much as they possibly can. You will need to purchase J-hooks in swivel form. So they come like this, buy these. These things are awesome and very necessary on a trap line, and J-hook specific pliers. They sell these on the trapping sites as well. You will need both of those. Trapping trowel is very handy. You will also need a sifter. I don't have one here because I drove over it with a tractor. I gotta order another one. And the last thing we're gonna cover in the next month's video is a dirt hole set. This has become my best friend on the trap line. It's very, very important for drilling and making the proper dirt hole set. This is a 2-inch auger bit. 2 inch has been the best for me. So, yeah, you'll need a drill if you're gonna use that. So, you can also make a dirt hole with a shovel. We'll go over both. But other than that, that is kind of the basics. These sites, FMT, they have starter kits as well. Take a look at those. Guys, there's no perfect way to do this. Everyone does it a little differently. I'm just showing you the way that I do it. When it comes to baits, if you want to target coyotes, you're going to want to purchase some coyote urine, bobcats, bobcat urine. All these various sites, FNT and Kendall sites, they have, if you're wanting coyotes, they'll have baits and lures specific for coyotes. If you're targeting bobcats, same. Same with raccoons, so on and so forth. So, you know, there's a lot of good information out there and a lot of poor information, but both of these places are places that I have personally used and they've treated me very well. Like I said, I am not sponsored by these guys. I just have a high regard for them and they're working the outdoors. So I'm really excited to get started in this further and actually take you guys out and do the hands-on type deal. But until next month's video, guys, thank you. Take care, and can't wait to set steel. Okay, so I forgot one thing. Wax dirt or wax sand. I purchased wax sand just because of the type of soil conditions I'm in. This is dirt or sand that has been mixed with wax and the wax melted into it. What that does is it causes water to run away from the trap, and I'll explain and show you guys how to use this. I buy a 20-pound bag at a time at the FNT post. Awesome stuff. You can make your own, but starting out, just buy a bag. You'll thank me later. One of the other things I wanted to touch on, you'll hear a lot of people talk about dyeing and waxing and boiling your traps. Kendall's traps are pre-coated. That's one of the reasons I really like them, as well as just the design of the trap. And they're made in the USA, so that's a plus. So trapping is very important in a management plan, but it's also something that's very meaningful and important to me because it's something that you can take kids out and do. And someone was kind enough to take me out when I was a little guy and run traps with me, and I really appreciate that. I've never forgotten that, and I enjoy taking kids and people out on a trap line. It's a good opportunity to explain to them why we do it and what we're doing. You know, it's important to shed a good light on this as much as we possibly can, because trapping gets a bad rap oftentimes, and it's not the case of how it really is, people's intentions behind it. So I can't wait for next month, guys. It's going to be great. Make sure to read your rules and regulations of your state where you're at. Please do that. It's very, very important that you follow the laws. And make sure that you're doing everything by the book. So I can't wait for next month's video, guys, where we get out and we actually lay steel. We'll see you there.